for today.
The former executive director of Mulago Hospital, Dr. Byarugaba Baterana, who was interdicted recently, has been grilled by the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament over 3.87 billion shillings that was received from the Ministry of Health to pay allowances for medical interns but was never recognized in the statements of financial performance.
The undeclaration and recognition of these funds is something that we pick interest, because it can be misused. Maybe this one today has been accounted for well, but what would it be in the near future? What was it yesterday? That is the concern.
What would be the reason for non-disclosure?
No reason really, but that was really omission, but we had mentioned it on page 5, note 7. And I'm here with the head of accounts who prepared the financial statement.
My question is that he's actually misleading us. They did not recognize it.
That's not a question.
So he needs to concede. Does he concede?
Committee members questioned Mulago Hospital management on why they deviated from the accounting policy that requires all transfers from the consolidated fund and other government units to be recognized by the accounting officer, suspecting that the motive was to misuse the funds.
Go back to accounting policy 1AXC. Once money is transferred to you, it is you to account, not so? I mean, to recognize, not so?
Transfers are not part of the budget appropriated to the then vote 161. They are not.
That's correct. Did you ask for it?
The transfers.
Did you ask for this money?
The money
come away from the word transfer.
The transfers, they come to pay the people on behalf of the ministry. It will be the ministry doing that work.
Okay.
But it passes money to us to pay the workers, the interns and such ones, because they are within Mulago. And it is not only us, it is very many hospitals.
Is recognition part of accounting for the money received? And the answer is yes or no.
Baterana fumbled to account for payments accounting to 1.47 billion shillings that was paid to non-existing liabilities. The committee discovered that Mulago Hospital paid Umeme 823 million shillings in excess to declare payables, whereas 648 million shillings was paid to the same entity in unsupported deposits.
You made payment for non-existent liabilities amounting to Uganda shillings 1,471,382,369 Uganda shillings. And therefore the amount that is 823,142,526 in excess of the declared payables. Good. Did you have an exit meeting?
I am not taking Korea, but you know, I have to understand these things so that actually people don't take me off.
Yeah.
So that they
do not create problems,
yes,
for you.
Yes, that is exactly what we are talking about.
Hmm.
Now, in the middle of the things, Ministry of Finance released money of 3.127 billion. Now, knowing that every year we cannot have paid all our electricity that we have used, so we say, since you have given it to us for electricity, here it is, have it.
Yes,
that is what we did.
And
although Mulago management defended themselves, saying the payment was made to Umeme, the committee faulted them for making advance payments without approval of the secretary to the treasury.
We declared 2.304,366,476 as our domestic areas in relation to Umeme. It is on page 33. And actually, we expected to get that amount of money in respect of
Umeme, the arrears.
However, we received 3.127,507,002.
Good.
Under the same item of electricity, Now, what we did was to set off the outstanding arrears of 2.3.
Correct.
Then the balance, the truth is we didn't get the permission to spend it, but we paid it to Umeme.
And you know that is why we were asking you the question.
And actually, you remained with some money, which was meant for the payables, but since you had settled the payables, you were lucky to have the balance.
Yes.
And what you did, you are then paid in advance.
Yes.
Yet you had also received through appropriation money for Umeme for that financial year. So beginning from there, so that we understand you.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.